Let us now discuss on the drawbacks of normal amplifier. In the same way, we can have the comparison between normal amplifier and the operational amplifier. So, why operational amplifier is more advantageous, I am going to explain you here. First of all, the factor we have to consider if you compare the normal amplifier and operational amplifier is the gain. In the normal amplifier, the transistor has a gain factor or current amplification factor, it lies between 25 to 500. So, the input voltage will be multiplied by suppose 500 times if the gain factor of transistor is 500 taken for the operation. So, input signals that will be maximum amplified at the output with 500 times. If you want a gain more than that of this, then we have to connect another amplifier at the output of first amplifier. So this is called as the one stage of amplification and this is second stage of amplifier. So in this way, if you want a higher gain, we have to connect a multi-stages like this. So we have to connect another amplifier like this and so on. So this forms a multi-stage amplifier in normal amplifier. So to require a higher gain, we have to connect like this. But connecting these stages in between one another, we have to couple these amplifiers using a coupling devices such as capacitor or transformer or all these things. But if you connect the capacitor here, it blocks the DC. So lower frequencies are blocking here. So at the lower frequency, this amplification factor will get on, goes on reducing. So gain will reduce if the DC signals or low frequency signals are connected here. So gain in normal amplifier is not much higher, but as far as the operational amplifier is concerned, the gain does not depend on the amplification factor of the transistor used there. So that is why gain in operational amplifier is very high. So this is the first factor. Second factor is the input impedance. Input impedance means if this is your amplifier and these are your input terminals. If you consider a resistance or total opposition of the amplifier at the input side, that resistance is called as impedance and that is denoted by suppose Z. It is at input, so that is why it is Zd. This input impedance should be high. Why? Because if you connect the signals at the input, these whole signals must be dropped at the input impedance so that all the voltage will be getting amplified perfectly. So this input impedance must be high. So in normal amplifier, because of the biasing conditions and some coupling devices are connected there, this input impedance is not too high. So input impedance in the operational amplifier is very high because it is directly coupled amplifier as it uses the differential amplifier. So second factor is the input impedance. So input impedance in normal amplifier is not too high. Third thing is the output impedance. In the similar way, at the amplifier stage, if this is your output, if you consider all the opposition at the output from the output terminals, that resistance or that opposition is called as the output impedance. Now, what should be the value of this output impedance? Output impedance should have a low value. I will say that it should have zero value. Why? Because if the inputs are amplified and suppose some voltages are appearing at the output, this all voltage should be given to the load. That means no voltage should be dropped here. If the value of resistance or value of impedance at the output, it has some value, this voltage will be dropped. And if this voltage is dropped, all the voltage will not appear at the load resistance. So this resistance must have the low value. But if you consider the normal amplifier, at the output of normal amplifier, mostly transistors collector is used and collector has connected with the power supply with the resistance. That resistance cannot be avoided. So that resistance has value.
So the resistance at the output cannot be zero. So that is why impedance at the output for normal amplifier cannot be zero. But as far as the operational amplifier is concerned, the output impedance of the operational amplifier is very low, and we can say that it is nearly above zero. So that is why operational amplifier is better than that of the normal amplifier. Fourth thing is the frequency response. Frequency response, it is nothing but the graph between the gain and the applied frequency. If you consider the normal amplification using the transistor amplifier or RC coupled amplifier, this gain of the amplifier, if you start increasing the frequency value, if you start increasing like this, then it will reach to up to a one maximum value. Then this gain will remain constant for some value of frequency, and then after higher frequency, the gain goes on reducing. So this is the frequency response of normal amplifier. Now, where the gain is getting fixed or constant, that is the bandwidth of the frequency response. So from F1 to F2, these are the frequency ranges where the gain is remaining constant, and this value for normal amplifier using transistor is very less. As far as the operational amplifier is concerned with the frequency response, the gain at 0 Hz frequency it is high, because the differential amplifiers are used in operational amplifier, and differential amplifiers are the direct couple amplifiers, so no coupling capacitors are there. So that is why low value frequency signals can also be getting amplified here. So at the 0 Hz frequency, the gain of operational amplifier is very high. And then after certain frequency, the gain start reducing, but the reducing factor, it will remain become 0 after 1 MHz. So you can see the bandwidth of this operational amplifier is much higher. It is from 0 Hz to 1 MHz. So all the frequency from 0 Hz to 1 MHz, they can be perfectly amplified between this frequency using this operational amplifier. So the bandwidth of operational amplifier is much higher, or frequency response is much higher than that of the normal amplifier using transistor. So the fourth factor is frequency response. The last factor is effect of input capacitance. In the normal amplifier, it uses the transistor inside it, and to connect any signal to this transistor amplifier, we have to block the DC coming from the previous stage. So that is why a coupling capacitor is used in the input stage. Then after, if collector has to be connected to another amplifier, power supply is used here, and this collector is directly connected to the power supply to a positive VCC. So same DC current can also flow through the collector, and this collector is connected to another stage, that is the base of the another transistor, and this current will also injected in the base of the transistor. If base is connected to the DC current, this current is also getting amplified at the second stage. So this current should not passes to the next stage. So for this, we have to use again a DC blocking capacitor as a coupling capacitor. So if you have a normal amplifier, there are coupling capacitors present in the operation of amplification. At the input, you can see if you input frequencies between 0 Hz to suppose 10 Hz, these are very low frequencies, and these are considered nearly about the DC. So this frequency, as they comes in the category of DC, they will be blocked here. So low frequencies cannot be passed through it. But in the operational amplifier, we do not require any coupling capacitor, because all the differential amplifiers are direct couple amplifiers. Direct means output of first stage can be directly connected to input of second stage. So collector of this transistor, it is directly connected to base of the second transistor. So this is why 0 Hz to 10 Hz frequency can easily pass through it. So effect of input capacitance is not present in the operational amplifier. Why? It is present in the normal amplifier. So that is why the lower value frequency or DC signals cannot be amplified by using a normal amplifier, but operational amplifier can easily amplify this. So these are the some drawbacks which are present in the normal amplifier, and we can compare both normal amplifier and operational amplifier using this. In the exam section, you might have been asked about this question, like what are the drawbacks of normal amplifier over operational amplifier, or in other way, it will be asked that what are the advantages of operational amplifier over the normal amplifier. So you can easily explain this factor. Hello dear student, today we will discuss on the chapter 4 in paper 1, that is operational amplifier. First of all, starting operational amplifier, we must understand the basic block diagram of this operational amplifier. Now I have drawn some blocks here. You can see there is the first block, and this block is called a differential amplifier. Now what is meant by differential amplifier? Differential amplifier is an amplifier which is used to amplify difference of two input signals. So difference is taken and that is amplified. The basic building block of this operational amplifier is the differential amplifier. In the differential amplifier, as I have already just told, that it has a difference of two inputs. So this differential amplifier has two inputs. One of the input is called as inverting input. And second is called as non-inverting. So differential amplifier basically amplifies two difference between two inputs. That is why one of the input is called as inverting input and another is called as non-inverting input. So if you say this is your V2 and suppose this is your V1, then the difference will be like this, V1 minus V2. So minus sign is connected to V2, so that is why this input is inverting and this is non-inverting. So this is the difference, and this difference is getting amplified using the differential amplifier 1. As this differential amplifier has two inputs, in the same way it has two outputs. So this is one output and this is second output. So this was the first block. After this first block, the output of this differential amplifier, it is connected again to another differential amplifier, which is connected after the differential amplifier 1. So outputs of first differential amplifier is directly connected to the second differential amplifier. One thing here is the differential amplifiers comes in the category of direct coupled amplifier. Direct coupled amplifier means these amplifiers can amplify AC as well as DC, because there is no coupling devices connected between the stages of amplifier. So these are the direct coupled amplifier. So that is why output of first differential amplifier, it is directly connected to second differential amplifier. Again, this is also a differential amplifier. So this also has two inputs and it will have two outputs. But in the operational amplifier, for further application, we don't need the second output. So that is why one of the output of differential amplifier, it is disconnected, or it is grounded here. So it is inhibited. Then after the two stages of amplification, direct coupled amplification, there is a circuit which is called as level shifter. Now what do you mean by level shifter? In the 11th standard, you might have seen the applications of pressure transistors as amplifier. The most popular configuration of amplifier is the common emitter amplifier using transistor. In the common emitter amplifier, we have also gone through the characteristics of
amplifier. So if you draw the output characteristics, in the output characteristics of common emitter amplifier, the output current is the collector current because the output is taken across the collector, and the output voltage is the collector to emitter voltage. So if you plot a graph between collector current and the collector to emitter voltage, the graph will be like this. Then this transistor must be biased and they should be in the active region for faithful amplification. So that is called as biasing. So input side is forward bias and output side is reverse bias. This is the when we want to use the transistor in the active region, the biasing should be like this, that input should be forward bias and output should be reverse bias. If input should be forward bias, it means that we have to provide some voltage at the input so that the diode between the base and emitter, it must be forward bias. And to make a diode in forward bias, we need a voltage of 0.7 volt to make a diode in forward bias. If you consider the minimum voltage to forward bias a diode, that will be 0.7 volt. And if you convert it into the current, that current will be near about 10 microampere. Right? Then if you plot a graph of collector current and collector to emitter voltage, and if the collector to emitter voltage will increase, this current, that is the collector current, it will start increasing like this and it will reach or linearly increase like this when the current or the voltage is 0.7 volt and if the current at the base of transistor is 10 microampere. So this is the current which is given to the base of the transistor, that is IV. Now here you can see that this is the biasing condition. Biasing condition means it is no signal to be amplified, it is applied now. So this is the zero signals condition when the transistor is biased. So in the differential amplifier also uses the transistor and they are also working in the common emitter configuration. And in common emitter configuration is there, same graph will be achieved at the inputs of this differential amplifier. Now this is the collector current which we are getting at the output. Now the transistor which are used in the differential amplifier, they have a current amplification factor, and this current amplification factor in common emitter, it is denoted by beta, and it is nothing but the change in the output current to the change in the input current. So this is the ratio which is called as the amplification factor. And at the manufacturing, this current amplification factor is fixed. We can have various beta factors of transistor, they are available in the market, but the values of this transistor lies between 25 to 500. So every transistor will have a beta value and that lies between 25 to 500. Now in the operational amplifier, the differential amplifier here used, it must have the high gain. So current amplification factor actually defines the gain of amplifier. So if you want high gain, we must have the gain factor which should be maximum. So suppose in this differential amplifier, if the transistor is used and suppose the beta factor of this transistor is used is suppose 500, then the 500 current beta factor will be getting multiplied by the current value at the base and it will appear at the output. See, if you calculate the collector current, it will be nothing but the beta times IV. Right? Now, at the input of differential amplifier, the transistor is used and transistor is connected to the 10 microampere of base current. So, this base current is getting multiplied by beta value and it will be appearing at the output. So, here no signal right now is connected. So, it is the zero signal condition. And we are correct getting the current as IC equal to beta times IV at this point. Right? Now, the collector current at this moment will be nothing but the transistor uses 500. So, that is why 500 multiplies by 10 microampere. This much current it is present right here when no signal is connected. So, this is the zero signal condition. After first differential amplifier, we are getting the output to the inputs of second differential amplifier.
Second differential amplifier, it is also a direct coupled amplifier. So the DC current can also pass through the input of differential amplifier second. Differential amplifier second, it is also made up of transistor, and this transistor are also connected in the common emitter configuration. So same type of graph will be appeared at the output of this. But here you can see at the output of second differential amplifier, I can draw the diagram of collector to emitter voltage and collector to collector current graph will be like this. But here the input at this phase was 10 microampere. But for this stage, the input of this transistor phase, it will be 500 multiplied by 10 microampere. So this will be the base current which is present at the input of this differential amplifier. Again, the differential amplifier, they are using the transistors, and transistor may have the beta factor of 500. So this current, it is also again getting multiplied by 500 at the output of differential amplifier second. So at the collector of this differential amplifier, the current factor will be like this: 500 multiplied by 500 multiplied by 10 microampere. So this much current is present at the output of differential amplifier second. So right now we have not inputted any input voltage, and we are getting the current at the output. You can see, we can consider this condition as, suppose we have an amplifier which is connected, which is normally used to amplify the signals from the computers. So that computer speakers, this stage is considering like this, that input of the amplifiers, they are connected nowhere, and we are getting the output, or we are getting the sound at the output. Is this possible? Because amplifier are the, when the input signals are given, it should be amplified and the sound should be produced. But here, if such type of amplifiers are used, what is happening? We are not connected any input, and we are getting some sound at the output. So this current should not be present here, and this current, it is the DC current, because no changing value current is inputted here. So that is why the current values are steady. So that is why this current is the DC current. So at the output, this collector current will be multiplied by 500 times. So it will be appear like this. So this current is presenting and it is flowing to the output. So this current is, should not be present. So we have to eliminate this current. So this current is eliminated using the circuit which is called as level shifter. So this will be the DC level which is present at the output of differential amplifier second, and this should be minimized, or this should be eliminated, and that can be done using a circuit which is called as level shifter. So that is why there is a stage which is called as level shifting, and this level shifting is done how? Ki this much current is present here, and we have to inject this much current with reverse polarity. Suppose the current at the output of differential amplifier second is positive 500 multiplied by 500 into 10 microampere, this much current is present here. We have to inject a current with reverse polarity, and that injecting is called as offset nulling. So one thing is there, that if the current present at the output of differential amplifier second, it should be nullified, and offset means the amplifier is off, that means no signals are connected at the input of the amplifier, and we are getting the output, and this output should be null, that means it should be bring back to the zero value, and that setting is called as offset nulling. Nulling means to bring it back to zero. So that is done with the level shifter circuit. So in this case, the current is suppose positive, it may happen that the current will be negative, because in the differential amplifier, the dual power supply is mostly used, and when dual power supply is used, this DC current present here, that may have positive as well as negative values. So sometimes we have to provide the negative voltage or negative current to be injected to bring the offset nulling, or sometimes we need the positive value. The main purpose of telling about the positive and negative current should be there. I will explain you in the pin diagram. That will be mostly you will understand that value why positive and negative voltages are there to inject the level shifting. So this is how level shifting is done. So here after the level shifting, the output current here will be nullified. So it will be comes to 0 ampere. So that is the main purpose of this level shifters. So the DC value of the current of output current, it will go on increasing because of the successive stages of amplification and the DC amplifiers are there. So that is why the DC value of current is getting increased, and this current should be bring back to zero. So that circuit which is used to do this is called as level shifter. In the same block, you can see there is a buffer circuit connected here. Now, in short, I will explain you buffer. Suppose this is an amplifier, this is its output, and this is suppose its input. Now, if this circuit is the buffer, then the voltage present at the input and voltage at the output will be equal. So that circuit is called as buffer. But the input resistances and output resistances of this circuit are different. So that is why the current in the input and current at the output will be different, but the voltages will be same. So that circuit which provides same in output as that of the input, but the currents are different, that type of circuit is called as buffer. Now, what is the purpose of buffer? Buffer is a circuit which has same input and output voltage, but currents are different. This circuit actually isolates the succeeding stages of the amplification. So, if you insert a buffer circuit, it will provide isolation. That means the current from this stages cannot flow to the next stages. So that is providing the isolation. That is the main purpose of this buffer circuit. After buffer circuit, this output is given to again an amplification stage at the output. In the operational amplifier, there are certain types of amplifications or amplifiers are there. One of the kind of amplifier is called as push-pull amplifier. And this amplifier comes in the category of class B. In the 11th, you might have learned about the classification of amplifiers. There are class A, class B, class AB. Then these amplifiers are used to amplify the waves of the signals. In class B amplifier, the output is remain on for the waves up to 180 degree, more than 180 degree. So that type of amplifier is called as class B amplifier. In this type of amplifier, there are two amplifiers which are used. One of the amplifier will, if two amplifiers are used, then there should be two transistors which should be used here. In this two transistor, one of the transistor is turn on, and at that time another transistor is off. So one transistor will amplify first half wave and second amplifier will amplify the second second half cycle. So one amplifier is turning on, at the same time another amplifier is turning off. So that action is push-pull type. So that is why this type of amplifier is called as push-pull amplifier. And class B, because the transistor is remain on for more than 180 degree. 180 of the cycle. So that is why that is class B amplifier. So this, at the output stage, this type of amplification is done, and we will get the final output at this stage. So this was about the block diagram of operational amplifier. In the exam section, we do not have to bother about what is a differential amplifier, how it works, and all these things. We have to just write the blocks, name of blocks. And we have to explain the what the block is doing, from where the inputs are coming and where the outputs are going. So we can seriously explain one block after each other, each, and we can explain this block diagram. This block diagram in the exam will come for 4 marks. So we have to draw this diagram and we have to explain each block or function of each block one after another. So that will secure your 4 marks. Now let us discuss on the advantages of operational amplifier. The first factor is the input impedance. As the input impedance is very high, we can have no loading effect for the stages. So it provides no loading effect. If it is connected between the stages, then operational amplifier has no loading effect. That means it does not load the succeeding stages of amplification. So first factor is the input impedance. Second factor, that it does not uses any coupling devices. So DC as well as the AC signals can easily amplify easily. So second factor, that it can amplify DC signals also. The third factor is the about gain. Gain of this amplifier, gain of operational amplifier is quite large. So it can be nearly about the infinity. We can have infinity gain. I will explain you later how infinity gain is provided by operational amplifier. So operational amplifier has infinity gain. So this is one of the advantages of operational amplifier. The fourth factor is the common mode rejection ratio. The common mode rejection ratio of operational amplifier, it is quite large. So if that this type of ratio is large, then that amplification is very perfect. So here the common mode rejection ratio, due to this high ratio, the output is noise free. So no interference due to the external signals can be achieved at the output. So it is noise free. So it has high common mode rejection ratio. Fifth advantage is the slew rate of this operational amplifier is much higher. Now what is meant by slew rate? It is nothing but the maximum rate of change of output with respect to time. This factor is called as slew rate. So this slew rate is a main thing, and it is much higher in operational amplifier. So that is why the output will not change with respect to time. So this is the fifth factor. The sixth factor is the output of operational amplifier is not getting affected due to the supply variation or temperature variation. So that factor is mostly occurs in the normal amplifier because they use transistor. And if you operate it for more time, that transistor or its collector is getting heated due to the high current at the collector. So heating effect also changes the output of normal amplifier because of the transistor. But in the operational amplifier, this effect is very less. So no temperature variation. Output. And no supply variation. If the supply fluctuates, then output also remains constant in the operational amplifier. But in the normal amplifier, if the supply voltage fluctuates, the output also varies. So this is the sixth factor. The seventh factor is, as it does not use any coupling devices, so it can also amplify low frequency signal, low frequency signals, or as well as the DC signals that can be also amplified using the operational amplifier. The eighth factor is, it is available in the IC package. IC package means all the circuit is fabricated on the single chip, and single chip has some terminals and we have to just connect them with the circuit. But in normal amplifier we have to use the transistor. So if more stages or more gain is required,
we have to connect the stages of amplifier, and one stage requires one transistor. So this is how that whole circuit will increase its size, and in the normal operational amplifier it can be done using a single IC. So it is available in the IC package. This is the very good advantages of operational amplifier. The ninth factor, that along with the amplification it can do many operations like addition, subtraction, then integration, differentiation. These all things, arithmetic operations, can be done using the operational amplifier. While with the normal amplifier we can't do this using normal amplifier. So this is one of the advantages. And the last advantage is that it uses the dual power supply. Why this is advantage? Because in normal amplifier, suppose we have a power supply of plus 10 volt and 0 volt, the output appearing at the output will have the maximum amplitude towards positive side, will be maximum up to 5 volt, and towards the negative side it will be maximum minus 5 volt. So the output swing at the output of normal amplifier depends on the power supply, and we use a single power supply, so due to which maximum swing will be plus 5 volt to minus 5 volt. So maximum peak at the positive can be only 5 volt. But if dual power supply is used, then see what will happen. We can have a swing up to 10 volt positive side and up to minus 10 volt towards the negative side. So if dual power supply is used, same power supply here in normal amplifier it is plus 10 volt, but here in the operational amplifier it is plus 10 volt and minus 10 volt. So you can see the output can swing up to 10 volt towards positive side as well as 10 volt towards the negative side. So total swing peak to peak, you can see that plus 10 volt to minus 10 volt. So total 20 volt of swing is appearing at the output. So operational amplifier has maximum amplitude at the positive side and maximum amplitude at the output side. So in this way we can have a greater swing at the output using dual power supply. So that is why this is the most good advantages of operational amplifier. So these are the advantages of operational amplifier, and they may be asked for 3 months. So remember this and learn this.